We're back!
Everybody!
Hi!
Hey! The girls are back in town because it's Movie Monday at the Mind Exhibit.
Yeah.
Do we all remember these two lovely, lovely girls? We've got my sister,
Anna,
and
Eden.
Today we're going to be talking about one of our most favorite films. Again, I mean, I feel like I could say that every single week. Well, I think it goes without saying that all these movies are going to be some of the best. But today we're talking about... Today we're going to be talking about a 2006 classic starring Sarah Paxton, JoJo, and Emma Roberts, Aquamarine! So for those of you who haven't seen Aquamarine, or if you've seen it, but it was a long time ago and you need a little plot recap, we're going to do our best to recap the plot from memory alone.
Oh god.
The movie starts out with this like dreamy intro of Aquamarine humming as she's swimming through the water. Very good, Anna. She's swimming along, and then she pops up, and then it's that one song that's like...
They're gonna drive us crazy. Let's
go! Okay, and then... Well, after that, it's the next night, so time is moving quite...
Quickly!
Time is moving quickly. And... they end up going to the pool again that night when it's dark out, and they bring some snacks.
Some fish sticks and some worms.
Gummy worms.
And gummy worms. They brought actual worms too,
Ew,
I think.
They did?
Yeah, I think so.
No, they didn't.
Well, yeah, because I think that they're, because Claire's like, what are you trying to catch it?
Those are fish sticks.
No, I'm trying to feed it. Well, she brought worms.
No, she
didn't. Well, I don't remember. But I could have sworn she brought worms. Okay, well, she brought gummy worms for sure.
Yeah, I just shortened them.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then all of a sudden, mm-hmm. And then all
Let's
of a sudden, they're fighting, just like us. They're just such sisters. And then...
I bet I know what it was.
I'm guessing
it was a mermaid.
And the girls are freaked out. And so they decide... you know, to come back and help her the next morning, because all of a sudden Leonard wakes up, and the next morning the girls go down and there's a maintenance guy.
The vision, you know?
Yeah. I mean, it was cute, but
I wanted that.
Oh, it was so cute. It was just so cute. But have you ever actually tried to do it with a shirt?
Mm-hmm.
Have you?
I'm kind of scared too.
Yeah,
you're scared.
I'm scared.
No, I just don't want to mess it up.
Yeah.
No, that's fair. And then they take her upstairs, and she starts jumping on the bed. And then her dad calls her on a shell, a conch shell that's in Claire's room.
Shell phone.
Yeah, so her dad says, you have to be back in 3 days, unless you can prove that. And then the next day, they're like, what is Aquamarine gonna wear to the last splash? Oh, because Raymond asked Aquamarine to go to the last splash with her.
He said, what are you doing tomorrow night?
Yeah, what are you doing tomorrow night?
Yeah.
And he said, I think you were at a lot of splash. And she didn't say yes or no, but...
because the sun was setting.
Yeah, because the sun was setting. So, but she does end up, you know, planning on going to the last splash with Raymond, which is the ultimate place to find love, the last splash. Like, yeah.
If only it was
I
real.
Know. And then... so they are like, well, Haley, she can't keep wearing her t-shirts everywhere.
Let's go shopping.
They go shopping. Shopping. And and sunglasses, like new outfits in addition to their last splash outfits. How did $400 cover all of that? I mean, this was like right
2006.
This was right before the 2008 recession. So honestly, things were probably thriving in 2006, 2005.
still, like, if only a mall trip cost only $400. Like, that's like one, that's one receipt at one store these days, which is crazy. This is where they go, and Aquamarine calls a couple of dolphins, and Claire doesn't want to go because she's still scared of the water, and this is when she tells Aqua that her parents drowned in a sailboat accident. Really sad, but Aquamarine had seen their boat, the Claire de Lune, long ago, and she was like, they inspired me to go find love.
That's how she knew love existed.
But Haley goes out to this buoy, and she gets two beautiful, identically shaped starfish, and Aquamarine's real. Haley's like, you know, sometimes we just don't have love. Like, her dad left her mom, and she says that love is the closest thing that humans have to magic.
My dad said he loved me. He said he loved my mother, and then he left us. But I guess that's just the way it is, and love doesn't always work. But I know that there's a reason why everybody wants it so much. And what's that? It's the closest thing we have to magic.
And even though Claire's parents passed away and Haley's dad left them, it doesn't mean that there's not still love in the world. And this inspires Aqua. Lifeguards stand, they're all watching the fireworks, super cute. And then all of a sudden, the mean girls pull up in the princess mobile to the water tower. And Celia climbs up and she takes the ladder away from the water tower. And then it's the next morning and Cecilia goes to her dad and she's like, oh, I went on my run this morning by the water tower and I heard some like crying. I think a girl is trapped up there. And her dad's like, did you call the police? No, I wanted to talk to you first. And he immediately calls the news station and there's this whole big news scene at the water tower and Haley and Claire see it, but they got into this
How he found her.
I feel like, well, he found her like little talisman thing at the bottom of the pool that one day.
Yeah, but how do you know that she was at the water tower and that she needed a ladder and like...
I feel like he just kind of moves in the shadows and he kind of gives me like... I feel like there's people that walk among us that are literally mythical creatures. And I don't even mean that in like a mean way, like looks or appearance wise, but I really do feel like some people are just more in tune with like... I don't know, stuff like that than others. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
I think that's why this kind of stuff, like, yeah, it's convenient, but it works because it kind of gives this secondary character, like, a little arc, you know? Yeah. Swim back, or Aquamarine swims away, she goes home, and they're saving their wish. They decide to save their wish, Haley is gonna move, and they say goodbye one last time, and it's so cute. It's such a good ending, too. I mean, it's like, it's not the ending that you would, like, expect from a kid's movie.
But it's not the typical, which I like.
Yeah, it's good because it's realistic and, yeah. So, the characters in Aquamarine are really great. And, you know, you've got the tropes of, like, the main character girlies that are kind of they embody that every girl kind of feeling of like they have some distinct personality traits. Like Haley's kind of more of a tomboy, and Claire, she's not really a girly girl, but she's, you know, she's afraid of the water and she's a little bit more timid and cautious. Haley's a little bit more bold, but you know, you can relate to one of them. Did you guys relate more to Haley or Claire as a child?
I think I was more of a Claire as a child.
Yeah.
I really wanted to be like a tomboy, so I was like, oh my god, Haley is so cool.
Yeah.
Like, I thought she was so cool, but I really wanted to be Aqua.
Oh, for sure.
Really bad.
Yeah. I feel like, well, Aquamarine is the aspirational, she's a little bit older than the other girls.
Mm-hmm.
You know, she's kind of like the big sister kind of vibe, or like, if you've ever had like a friend crush on someone, like, oh, I really want to be her friend.
Yeah.
Like, we all have that kind of like older girl that we think is really cool that we want to be like. But also Aquamarine is experiencing the world for the first time and like the world of boys and the world of friendship, and that's all kind of nicely incorporated. And then even the mean girls I think are really well done. Like, you know, there's like the stupid one, there's the sidekick lackey that's like that could overthrow the queen bee at any time. And then of course, yeah. And then of course the main mean girl, Cecilia. I mean, it's clear that she is really confident, she's really girly, she's pink, she's flirty, but she's you know, she's driven. She goes for runs. She does stuff for attention.
Mm-hmm.
You know, she wants her appearance to be good, but she's a pretty good Mean Girl character. And she doesn't give up in pursuing Raymond. And I don't even think it's because she likes Raymond. I think it's just because she wants that appearance of, like, having the guy that everyone is after.
That's, like, every Mean Girl ever. Like, always the cheerleader who wants to be dating the quarterback.
Right.
You know what I mean?
But it's all good, though. And then even, like, the side characters, like, we talked about Leonard a little bit in the plot recap, but, like, you know, he's kind of, like, a gentle giant, kind of mysterious, kind of...
He kind of gives, like... Oh, what's his name? And To Kill a Mockingbird.
Oh, Boo Radley.
Yeah.
He is so Boo Radley.
That kind of, like, seems like everyone's kind of scared of him.
Yeah.
And, like, we don't really know how to feel, but actually he's, like, one of the sweetest people you've ever, like, encountered if you give him a chance.
You grow to like him like Haley and Claire grow to like him.
Yeah.
Like, at the same time.
Yeah, for sure. Claire's grandparents are... I wonder if they're the mom's parents or the dad's. I have a feeling they're
the
mom's. Yeah.
Yeah.
They give mom grandparent vibes.
Yeah, they do. They give, like, girl dad.
Yeah, for sure. And then, Haley's mom is actually really... She's gorgeous.
She's stunning.
She's so pretty. I feel like I've seen her in other stuff.
Right?
Like, she looks like she was, like, maybe on Lost or something.
I haven't seen Lost.
I haven't either, but I feel like it seems like she'd be on, like, she seems like she'd be, like, a good, like, an Emmy Award winner, like, a TV
yeah.
show actress, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
But she was really good, and you could really sympathize with her, like, even as a kid, too, and I feel like sometimes when you're watching a kid's movie, you don't really sympathize with the parent's point of view or, like, the adult point of view.
Yeah.
But even as a kid, you can really feel her frustration and how she feels bad that she's moving, but she has to do it for her career. I mean, she's a single mom.
Yeah.
Her husband has left her alone.
And she used to get, like, annoyed about how Haley talked to her.
Yeah, she was mean to her mom.
Yeah.
And, you know, you can understand her frustration and stuff, but I think they did that concept really well. And then, I think last but not least, we have to talk about...
Have any thought about how to deliver it for days? Like, he just sat on that, like, and he really executed it really well.
He really made the defensiveness.
Yeah, he brought it, you know? Like, he took out all the other competition.
Oh my god, yeah.
I'd say he, like, completely one-upped Emma Roberts. Like, I think I think he deserves something for that. Like, give
Oscar.
Him an Oscar.
I drank a pool!
Alright, hello again. We're back on screen to finish this video. We're wrapping it up. We have a few more things to say about Aquamarine that just need to be said. So first of all, this movie is about a mermaid, obviously. And mermaids equal girlhood.
Facts.
Discuss.
H2O. Mako mermaids, aquamarine. Do I need to say anything else? Like,
Ariel.
But the thing is the difference between, like, these mermaids and, like, Harry Potter.
Oh,
those are sirens.
Yeah,
this is different. I think we need to discuss the difference between sirens and mermaids. Mermaids is for the girls. Sirens is for, like, the mythical creature freaks. You know what I mean? Like, not that they're freaks, but, like,
no,
you know what
yeah.
I'm saying? Like.
They're for, like, the biblically accurate...
Yeah, like, we don't need any of that. Like, this is for us. Like, there are beautiful women swimming in the ocean. And I believe that that's true.
Well, and I think that one of the very exciting things... Exciting. It's so exciting!
She's a mythical creature freak.
One
of mast.
Honestly, though, one of the really fun parts about girlhood is growing up believing that magic is real. And, you know, whether you actually...
Yeah.
Like Santa, you know, like whether or not you actually believe in magic as a child, when you're growing up as a girl, you want to be a mermaid, you want to be a fairy, you want to be a princess when you grow up, little boys, bless their hearts, want to be garbage truck drivers, mailmen, firemen, police officers. I mean, not every little girl wants to be a princess or a mermaid or a fairy, but many do.
And there's many different things that can, I think that can kind of stem into growing your personality as a girl, like whether you liked pink or purple. I mean, those are two very different things to little girls. Whether you wanted to be a mermaid or a fairy. And I feel like we were all pink mermaid girls growing up. Like, we weren't purple.
Until my tomboy phase.
Right. I mean, I actually hated the color purple, which is funny because my mom decided to paint my wall lilac growing up.
Okay, but I loved your room. It was so cute.
It was really, no, and there was nothing to hate about purple. It just was like what purple represented to being a girl. I mean, we all grew up doing ballet and, you know, those kinds of things. And I don't think we were the girliest girls out there. I mean, Anna kind of was.
Like, kind of, though. Like, not
like,
even.
Not real. Like, we weren't really girly, but, like, I feel like mermaids were that neutral territory of, like, it's, like, you know, half mythical, half normal girl. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, it was, like, magical powers meets just being a girl.
And, like, I think every girl at least once in their life has, like, played mermaids in the pool.
Oh, and I think we still do.
I love playing mermaids
in the pool. It's so, what's your mermaid name?
Oh my god, I always go for like a classic like ocean one, like coral or like something like that. Oh my god, the worst thing ever is when my friend, we're not really friends anymore, awkward to get out, this girl that I played mermaids with,
this girl,
we were like, okay, like what color is your tail? And she was like, clear. And we were like, wait, so like you can see like the bones and everything? And she was like and all like the little like flesh parts in the tail? And she was like, yeah. And I was like, this is, I don't want to play with you anymore.
Clear
is crazy.
That's so crazy.
Like, even for like the top,
yeah,
like just nothing, just nothing. She's like clear,
absolutely terrifying.
Like, I see the vision, I understand the vision. Like, yeah, I really do.
That would actually be kind of sick.
I think I almost said that once before, but like, I meant like translucent. Okay, like, wait, you can't see like the bones or anything like that. But she's like, I was like, oh, you can see the bones. She's like, yeah. I was like, okay, I'm not following anymore.
I just had a vision of like, what if you had a mermaid tail, but you had like little fish swimming inside of your tail. No, like in a cute way.
I see the vision, but like that executed would completely
In real life that'd be weird. But
I see the vision.
But Anna, do you ever remember your name or like what we'd always pick?
So mine kinda varied, but I was always a pink mermaid tail.
Pink tail. What color tail did you have?
I think I just went off like what bikini bottoms I had on.
Oh, that's cute.
Yeah.
I was always like a blue or like a teal kind of girl. I would always pick like Sandy or Shelly.
Yeah, Sandy. Sandy was a big one for me too.
I loved that name actually.
Yeah, see, it's like the ocean name. So you have to have like an ocean name. Yeah.
Right?
And what was your power?
Did you pick a power?
I picked a power.
I don't remember power.
What? I would like talk to the sea creatures and I would create waves.
Oh, that's actually so cute. Okay. But yeah, I mean mermaids, girlhood, it's important to talk about these things. And I also want to say, like, so we just watched Magic of the Pegasus, Anne and I, last night. And we actually hadn't seen it, and it was one of the newer old Barbie movies, you know, like still when they were doing fantasy, still when like Kelly Sheridan was like the voice actress and stuff, but like it did not hold up to like some of the classics like 12 Dancing Princesses,
Swan Lake,
Nutcracker,
Princess and the Pop Rapunzel,
all of those
movies I could like eat, you know what I mean?
Yes, they're like
scrumptious. They're scrumptious.
But
looking.
that's girlhood though. It's like wanting to eat like a trinket.
Yeah.
It's like you chew on the
poly. You basically just called me a biter. Like you literally just said like I bite people. Like that's what you just called me.
You would do that though.
I never actually bit you.
No, but you would like threat.
I think I bit you once.
Yeah, because that was on mom and dad's bed. You didn't like that, so you bit me.
Okay. How do you remember that and I don't?
Because you were
apparently I was livid and I don't even remember it.
Oh my god. But anyways, I was gonna say like the another Barbie movie that did not hold up for me was the Mermaidia movie.
I didn't like Fairytopia.
Yeah, that
fuck Fairytopia. Fuck Mariposa. Fuck Mermaidia.
I agree. No, Mariposa was good.
No.
I liked that one.
I don't know.
It was Thimble.
Okay, well,
wasn't that the little like goblin people? Were that thing?
Oh,
that
Thimble.
One?
That's what I'm thinking of.
Thimble is crazy.
much cuter than Bibble.
Fuck Bibble. I hate Bibble.
Yeah.
I hate the monkey in 12 Dancing Princesses.
Yeah.
I hate the purple dragon in Rapunzel.
I hate the elephant in the Island Princess. That,
why does it have eyelashes?
Why?
Why does it have eyelashes?
And why does it have why does it have a nose in addition to the trunk? Did you notice that?
Ew!
Yeah, the character design.
That's disgusting.
Flopped. But anyways. I love this topic. We could go on, but I do want to move on to. Okay, the next thing we want to talk about is the aesthetic of the movie in general, and this differs from girlhood and mermaid subjects because this movie came out in 2006. This was like right after the Y2K, like, you know, in the peak Y2K era, right before 2008, the recession. This was when girls were girling and, you know, Paris Hilton, all that stuff. And I think there's like a thing online called the coconut girl aesthetic. And this movie is the blueprint for that whole aesthetic. Like, you know, what really defines that aesthetic to you? Like,
for this like movie. The bright pink hibiscus flowers mm-hmm. on like the little halter tops.
Yep.
Like low-waisted cargo shorts, mm-hmm. the blue highlights.
Mm-hmm.
Claire's room, period. Like, literally right. just Claire's room.
Just her room.
Period.
Yeah.
Just that whole vibe. And that movie shaped me.
Yeah.
This movie literally shaped
it
me.
It really did.
Everything that I wanted my aesthetic to be.
Yeah. It kind of did. And I feel like the beach, even,
mm-hmm.
and the Last Splash yeah. dance.
The outfits.
Island in the Sun by Weezer. I mean, Weezer's not even a good band. And actually, a fun fact, I went to the Weezer concert at the Minnesota State Fair with one of my good friends from high school, and, yeah, I was there.
Yeah.
It is a band, but that song is good.
Buddy Holiday.
Who?
What's with the this is my girl.
You wanna know that song? I think I do know that song. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That was really awkward.
I know like a...
Can you cut that out for me?
I thought you were trying to say Buddy Holiday.
No, Buddy like, Holiday.
When
okay, wait.
When Sharon Clueless is like, I love him about Billie Holiday.
You guys need to hear the song now.
Okay.
A bit bussy.
Debussy?
Oh, it's that song.
Yep.
I did know that song. Yep.
Yep.
But that whole aesthetic, and then of course, like, I feel like even Cecilia's whole aesthetic is really coconut girl. Like, her haircut, the tan.
Fuck ass bob.
I mean, it looks good on her though.
No, she ate. She's like tiny.
She was in John Tucker Must Die.
Yeah, and she was in Gilmore Girls.
Oh yeah, she was Lindsay, wasn't she?
Justice for Lindsay.
I was just gonna say Justice for Lindsay from Gilmore Girls. Did you watch Gilmore Girls?
Yeah. And yeah. I hate Rory Gilmore.
I think we all do. But there's so many video essays about Rory on YouTube that are so good. Like, I've seen so many good ones, I don't even know if I could link them all below. But, anyways. Last but not least, it's gonna get emotional in here.
My stomach just sank.
We have to talk about the ending one more time and the friendship between Haley and Claire. And, you know, we all had that one friend in elementary school especially, and middle school, like those early days where they moved away and they were your best friend. For me, it was my best friend, Isul. We were like tight in seventh grade. I was like the new kid at school that year, and she moved back to France, and it was so sad. I mean, did you guys have a friend that like you loved that moved away? Or like something like that, you know, that switched schools, like
Cynthia.
Yeah, Sin switched schools.
She went to Blake.
Did you? You had a friend that moved away.
Did I? Oh, Jack. Ella.
Oh, and Jack. Ella and Jack. Yeah, I mean, we all had that experience, and I think it feels like the end of the world when you're a kid because you don't know. I mean, you're navigating the world for the first time. You're trying to figure things out as you go, and a constant leaves your life, and it kind of takes away that magic. And I think childhood is really all about
you know, it's really sad, but, you know, magic leaving a little by little every single day as you grow up, and, you know, friends moving away, and you find out that Santa Claus wasn't real, even if your mean sister told you.
Yeah.
I still have a grudge against you for that.
Well, I was like 9.
You were laughing at me. You were not 9. I was 9.
You were 9?
I think I was 9.
Well, I remember when my dad told me that Santa wasn't real. Like, I knew he wasn't real, but it's just like those kinds of things. I mean, they completely rock your world as a child, and it's really about preserving that magic as you grow older and learning from these experiences. But also, you know, like Haley says in the movie, love is the closest thing we have to magic, and it's really cheesy, but it's true. And, you know, even with loss, even with things being really difficult, I mean, no matter how far down you can go, there's always going to be some sort of love that keeps you holding on. And it's really hard to put this into words, but, you know, Eden's moving off to college in just a few days, actually. And she's the little one. She was actually born in 2006. And please don't cry. Sorry. But, I mean, and this is Eden's journey, but it's the end of our family's childhood, and these are the kinds of things that we go through in life, and I mean, we're here right now, we're just like sitting in Eden's room, and it actually used to be filled with her stuff, and I mean, if you want, I can link your TikTok that went viral.
Like, if you ever want, like, inspo on how to make a really vibey and cool, like, yeah. She's the girl to do it.
Yeah, my room got destroyed. I came home from camp and it was emptied out. I'm like, I feel like I'm living in a padded room right now. It's like, I feel like I got home and I'm like, oh my god, is this like a punishment? Like, what did I do wrong? But no, it's lovely. It's a lovely room. I made it better. It's fine. Add some lights, you know? Put some sheets on the bed. We're good.
Right? I'm sorry to make you cry.
No. You just said college and I cried. It's gonna happen.
I mean, and Anna had a really bizarre experience going to college in 2020 because of obviously the pandemic. I had a tough time at school. I moved away from home. And being the first one, it was like my parents didn't really know the process, but I mean, Eden is ready. And, you know, you might not feel ready, but you definitely are. Well, with that, I don't know how to end the video now. I think it's hard to say goodbye. It's hard to end this video. After that, but if anyone else out there that's watching, I mean, good grief, is going through a transition right now, just know that there is art out there for you to turn back to, and, you know, movies like Aquamarine, where it feels like the world was simpler, and, you know, whatever that means to you, and, you know, reach out to the people that love you. Just know that at the close of one thing, there's also the beginning of the next. And always try to keep preserving your magic however you can. And yeah, that's what life's all about, man. Yeah, this was a video essay about aquamarine.
Thanks for watching.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you guys so much for watching. Please like and subscribe. Share this video around. It was so great to see you. Thank you so much for visiting the Mind Exhibit this movie Monday. And this is where we leave you. Bye. Bye.
that I'm not afraid to use.